Kate Murdoch is a local artist and inveterate hoarder. She finds it hard to throw things out and collects objects from charity shops and even friends' garages.
10x10, yeah, well, it was first launched as part of Deck the Deck Arts Festival. And the idea was that it was actually inspired by a mammal called a pack rat. So I've had this idea in my head for about 20 years or so. And Deptford X were having their 10th anniversary, and my twin sons were going to be 10 in that year, and my grandmother was 100 years old. So all in all, the 10s all seemed to fit. And I had this idea, and as you all know, because you've seen, I had a huge collection of stuff that I've been collecting for years and years. So I thought it's a real good opportunity to give up 100 objects, and they all mean something to me, meant something to me in their own way. And so that's the whole principle behind 10x10. You know, the whole idea of 10x10 was that people left something in the place of whatever they took. So I mean, they're all in here. This box is full of the objects that people left behind as part of the exchange, and also some of the original things that were never swapped. The cabinet was made, personally made, and a lot of people think it might measure 10x10, but it doesn't. But it is 10x10 boxes, 100 boxes, which I had made specially, and it contains, when it's full, 100 objects which I've given up, 100 objects which are precious to me for one reason or another. And the idea is that it's actually a piece of work that you can look at, engage with, and then you can actually participate in it.
Because of the success of the installation at Deptford X, the art department at Lewisham College has invited Kate to set up the project in the college reception area.
People are certainly going to notice it's in a great place, and it just depends. You put it up, hope it'll be good, well received, but people may not engage with it at all, but I suspect they will. Excitement and trepidation. You do sort of think, oh, all that work, we've, you know, never mind, have some lunch. Let's have lunch.
After being displayed in the college for a week, the 100 objects are now due to be swapped.
Yeah, I managed to get the Aston Martin DB6 for Michael. So my life very much depended on that, so I had to be here. And this is the one that is actually missing from his collection. That is why I had to camp here overnight to ensure that I got it for him.
That's my country flag. Yeah, and it's really precious to me, so that's why I'm keeping it there.
Because I want to live to be 100 before I die.
I still can see the ones that I put in very clearly because they're still in my mind. But the things I want to go aren't going, that's the trouble. Never mind, I can't control that either. I want that yellow bowl to go big time. I really
If you teamed up with the person that got the puncture repair kit, yeah, you could use the super glue to stick this back on.
So we've now got sound effects in the cabinet. Don't give me no back talk,
lover. Make me mad. I'm going to teach now with my pipe in my hand. Beware.
Because so many students eat chicken. Okay, and I thought the box, the whole thing reminded me of lots of little battery head cages. So it's a little protest. I'm going to go for the love letter because I'm a very nosy person.
The principal wanted this one. Well, you didn't tell me that one, no.
No, I didn't take it. I haven't got it.
Oh dear, thanks for putting me on the spot with that one.
Oh no, It's very tragic. I gave her everything. My thoughts, my body, sky, face, my words, and even my art. And all I want is just a bit of love. Yes, a bit.
I'm thinking of taking the world's greatest dad statue because I feel that it's really cool in my name because I am a dad myself and my dad and my little boy keeps calling me the greatest, so I'm thinking of taking it for myself. I'll leave behind a stack of poker chips because they're very sentimental to me because I used these particular chips when I was on stage last year doing the acting course.
There was a chocolate chicken.
Yeah.
In an egg box with batteries around it. So it was a battery chicken in a little huddle.
In a little box.
The thing that said, get me out of here on it.
Love it.
Because students eat so much chicken. And it lasted about 5 minutes before some chocoholic student came along and nicked it.
It's a ring. It reminds me of, it was bought for me by my first ever girlfriend, and it kind of reminds me of when I had an ideal view of relationships that obviously deteriorates as you get older. I think it's about time I let that go and kind of realised what relationships are about. I'm actually going to take it with me to uni and probably use it. As I said, I think it'd be a good sort of source of information in the morning when I'm sort of having self-doubts. I can look at it and be like, well, actually, this was a piece of art. Someone's made this. They've made it through. It's like an eye kind of thing.
I've lost quite a lot of babies, you see. So I've got one little baby at home that kind of represents one of them. And I think it would take me many, many years to make a collection. So it's very important to me that, because it's going to be the second piece in my collection. It's not too hard for me to give these up, but accepting that is very difficult.
The reason why I wanted the car was because it's a James Bond car, okay? But it's not an original toy James Bond car.
No.
With all the guns and whatever else, but this is like what you call a third generation one.
Right, okay.
Not a lot of people collect these ones.
No.
Okay.
All right.
And I collect toy cars.
Okay,
all kinds.
How do you?
So when I first saw it, I knew I had to have it. So I got Herbie here.
Herbie, I know, the lovely Herbie.
The lovely Herbie to swap it for me, you know? So thank you very much. Brilliant idea.
It's the Friday after the exchange day, but in spite of Kate's rules that the swap takes place in a single day, not everything has been left as it was.
So right, it's now Friday, the 12th of March, 3 days after exchange has taken place. Tuesday's exchange was a really good day, and there were some things left, very heartfelt things left, I think. And overall, I think the Lewisham community, college community itself, very proud and very pleased to see that. We've got a few more travel cards and we've got a photograph which I know was exchanged some RISLA papers, which is as far as stupid as you can get, really. There are six things in total that should be there and aren't. The blue movie camera with a silver ring for a red rubber man, the white china swan and a stylophone. The last thing to go was, it's interesting actually, it was a post-it note and that was just put in its place, so I've missed a story on that if there is one. I am sad about the fact that six of the items have just gone. It just takes away the purity of the project, which I'd really hope to sort of hold on to, but you know, it's a learning curve. And that moment was, I think the Swiss Army penknife must be up there, a student who really thought about the project. Other things were like the ring being left behind. I thought that was a very symbolic gesture to leave a ring. I mean, the fact that the principal took part, I think, is amazing. From the people who picked it up, and then the man who took it upon himself to paint the legs, because it's been great, actually. Really good, positive experience. So it's not just the interaction, it's the sort of people and things around it that made it really, really good. And it's given me a very good impression of Lewisham College.